This tutorial is going to show you how to do an ordinal regression in SPSS. So regression is a technique used to assess the strength of a relationship between one dependent variable and independent variables. Linear regression requires the dependent variable to be measured on a continuous scale. However, there may be situations where you want to predict an outcome that is ordinal. This means you have a categorical variable that has a built-in order, but the gaps between the categories are not the same. Like if you're using a Likert scale that ranges from strongly disagree to strongly agree. So this is when you want to use an ordinal regression, sometimes also called an ordinal logistic regression. In this tutorial, we're going to assess student confidence level based on age, grade, and test result. So we have an ordinal dependent variable of confidence, which is measured on an ordinal scale of between 1 and 5. And we have our independent variables. We have age and test score, which are measured on a continuous scale because they can be any number. And we also have grade, which is measured on an ordinal scale of between 1 and 10, a bit like our GCSE scores. So to run an ordinal regression on SPSS, you go to Analyze, Regression, and then Ordinal. Then you need to add your variables. So you add your ordinal dependent variable to the dependent variable box, so in this case, confidence. Then you add any nominal or ordinal independent variables to the factor box, so in this case, grade. And then you add any scale or continuous independent variables to the covariance box. So in this case, we have age and test score. Then you want to click Options and make sure Logit is selected from the link box. This is usually the default, but you do want to check this as it is making sure it is doing an ordinal logistic regression. And then you can run the analysis. So the first box you'll see is the case processing box, and this tells you how many cases are in the analysis. So as you can see here, we have 16 valid cases in our regression. The next box is the model fitting information, which tells you if there's a significant improvement compared to the null model. Here we can see there is a significant difference compared to the intercept only model, which is our null model, and our final model. The next box is the goodness of fit box. This tells you if the model adequately fits the data, where a p-value of less than 0.05 indicates a poor fit to the data, and a p-value of greater than 0.05 means that there is no difference between the observed data and the fitted model. In most cases, people look at both the Pearson and the deviance test. Here you can see we do have a conflict in results, but obviously our regression was run on a very small data set. The next box is pseudo R-squared. And we calculate a pseudo R-squared because you cannot get R-squared for logistic regression. So while our model is not technically explaining variation, you can use this as an approximate measure of variation. So for ordinal models, we use the McFadden number. So in this case, we can say there has been a 34.8% improvement in the prediction of our dependent variable based on our independent variables in our model. And then finally, the last box is our parameter estimates. And these estimates show the probability of a case falling above a given category in the dependent variable. A positive estimate, so for example, like our grade 4, indicates an increase in likelihood of a case falling into a higher category of the dependent variable. So what this means is that people with grade 4 scores were more confident. A negative estimate, like age, indicates an increase in likelihood of a case falling into a lower category of a dependent variable. So what this means is that as people's age increased, they become less confident. However, as you can see from this box, at the sig line, none of our variables were significant. But again, this was just an example, so it was run on a very small amount of data. So this was just a quick tutorial to show you how to run an ordinal regression in SPSS. Thanks for watching.